Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about our upcoming unit study on volcanoes. I'm going to talk about the unit study itself, some extra resources I'm going to be using, as well as how I get our unit studies set up and ready to go. Next unit study is going to be volcanoes. We just finished up our first unit study of our homeschool year, which was the human body, and we really enjoyed that. We are about to go on vacation. Actually, we're leaving in 2 days, and I am, instead of packing, I'm filming a video. That's how badly I don't want to pack. So I have some free time, which I should be using to pack. However, I decided to film a video because I just don't know what to pack. And so that's where I'm at. So we're going on vacation. We just wrapped up the human body. And when we get back, there's a couple weeks before our next like quarter starts. And just because I'm crazy and a planner, I have these smaller unit studies that I got from Bookshark that only take like a couple weeks to maybe 3 weeks at most to complete. And so I thought it would be better to fit one of these in. And then once we start our new quarter, we can start our larger fall unit study. So with that being said, we're leaving in 2 days. I wanted to prep everything, get everything ready, so when we get back in town and we're ready for school, everything is ready to go. I don't have to print, organize. We can just open up and go. We are taking, this is our biggest break off of school so far. I did travel earlier in the school year, but my kids were still doing school even though I was gone. So they are taking, I think when I counted it, they are taking 11 full days off of school just due to normal days off, and then obviously our vacation. And so this will be a pretty big break, and so we're gonna have to get back into that school flow when we get back. So the unit study that we're going to be doing is the volcano unit study from Bookshark. Bookshark offers, I want to say maybe they're up to five free unit studies. It's a really good way to get some exposure on how Bookshark works. They are a literature-based curriculum. I really like these mini units because it's like one book. They plan everything out for you, which I will show you in just a minute. And they're quick. Sometimes, you know, those longer unit studies, you're like, okay, I want to move on. Like, you enjoy it, but they're just so drawn out sometimes that it can be a little bit much. But these ones, they're super quick. And so this is technically a 2-week unit study, 4 days a week. So there's 8 days of lessons. I don't know, because we only school 4 days a week, I don't know if we're going to do it every school day. We probably could. I glanced over it and the lessons aren't too intense, but I'm aiming to get this done within 3 weeks at the most. So if you're not familiar with Bookshark, they give you this instructor's guide, which lays out what books to read, what activity sheets, and then it has notes for every day, which include like vocabulary, discussion questions, and all of that. So they do a lot of like the planning, lesson planning type stuff for you, which is really awesome. For this unit study, this instructor's guide is completely free. All the information you need, the only thing you would need to get to go along with this is the book How Hot Is Lava by Kelly Smith. You can get it at your library if you do want this to be a completely free unit study, or you can find it on Amazon. You can purchase it through Bookshark, Thrift Books, wherever you can find it. It's paperback. I found it. I bought it through Bookshark just because I was buying other things from them. This says it's $6.95 US, so it's not an expensive book by any means, and it has tons of cool information. You basically, how it's going to guide you is, so on day one, you're going to read pages 6 to 7 and 14 to 15, and it does look like it's skipping around a little bit, so just keep in mind there's a method to why they're doing that. And then it comes with activity sheets, so those are free, and they look like this. So this is week one activity sheet. They're labeling a volcano, the Earth's cores. There's like a crossword puzzle. So it will tell you when to do an activity sheet. But basically it looks like there's one activity sheet per lesson. So, and they're not crazy. There's some mapping activities, so they're going to map where all the volcanoes are in the world. Nothing super heavy, not super writing intensive, just quick labeling, things like that, just to check for comprehension, which I like. I do like worksheets for that aspect. So all of those are included. It does give you different vocabulary, so depending how you want to do vocabulary, we have like a science journal we can write our vocabulary in. There are discussion questions. I don't know what grade level these units are for. Honestly, I think they're so adaptable that you could use them across various ages. My second grader and fourth grader will obviously be doing them together, but then my three-year-old's obviously gonna have to be sitting with us, and so we'll kind of see what he can do. Bookshark does add in some fun activities. So this one with graham crackers, and it looks like pudding or something. It is about like tectonic plates and boundaries, and so that's just like a super easy activity, but I would look through the book so you know if you have everything you need. There's a recipe for a lava cupcake, which obviously it's not real lava, but it's fun for kids. I know my kids are very excited for that. And I think, I'm trying to see if there's any more like really hands-on. It has some extra recommended things as well. Different like videos to watch, more books to read in the very back if you want to go further. And obviously I went on Pinterest. There's like this really cool slime recipe. Obviously you can make a volcano, so that's really cool. What I do whenever I have a unit study is I just kind of see like what do we already have to go along with it. And so this one, just like what I showed you, that's all you really need to complete it, and it can be completely free and take up 2 to 3 weeks. So there's a free engaging science lesson for you guys. But I know that my kids could probably handle a little bit heavier of a workload, and so I just wanted to see what else we had around the house. So I do have this book set. It's called the Horrible Geography book set, and this book is Violent Volcanoes. If you've never read from this series, they are hilarious. Very sarcastic book writing, very funny. Because it is so, I would say, like sarcastic, and it's not just like point blank, like they're, you know, they're kind of like making fun of certain things, and you kind of have to think about what they're saying. It does go over my second grader's head sometimes. However, I'm pretty sarcastic anyways when I talk to my kids, so they at a very young age have learned how to infer that. But anyways, these books are funny. They're not for everyone, but if you have a sense of humor, I would recommend trying them out because I like them. I can actually get through these read alouds on typically some maybe not such so engaging topics, and they make it absolutely hilarious and fun, and it is educational. So they have like little comics in there, like little quizzes, like they just make it really fun. And so I was like, oh, this will go perfectly. And so we are going to do this along with that as like a read aloud. Maybe we'll read this at night or maybe part of the lesson. It just depends how we're feeling during those lessons. Also, as I was looking around, I remembered I had bought this kit, Amazing Earth, and it does have a Erupting Volcano, the complete kit, everything you need. So definitely gonna do that. My kids want to make a volcano, but because this, it says it has everything you need, I'm hoping that that's true. But I've looked them up. It doesn't seem hard. You can use like Play-Doh or clay, or you can buy like an actual volcano kit on Amazon for like $15. So, I've had this, I'm gonna open this up and get that ready. And so that it will be like a fun activity we can do as well. So I gathered all that stuff. The way I've been storing my unit studies are in these like rectangle baskets from Target. These are my like all-time favorite thing ever. I bought them new for this homeschool year, and they were good for unit studies because unit studies have like a lot of books, a lot of just like things. They all fit in here. All the books can stand up because it's rectangle. Even those big books fit in here, those big picture books. Has the handle, so I carry this all around from our homeschool room to my room to downstairs, wherever we need it. And you can kind of see because it's not completely closed off. So this is like game changing. If you don't have a basket like this to carry your unit studies around, please get one because it's amazing. So I just took all of our human body stuff out of this. I put that in a box for storage. And so I'm going to fill this up with the geography stuff. Obviously, we don't have as much because it's only a couple weeks study. I also found these folders this school year too. So they have like a clear front and then they have like prongs to hold three hole punch and some pockets. I use them for my daughter's human body studies just because they have activity sheets, just stuff to like store it during the unit study. So I'm gonna switch these out. I made new little volcano covers on Canva. I make everything on Canva, and like they have like little images. I pasted them, volcano unit study, that's about it. So these are super simple. I'm just going to take out that one and place the new one in, and now we have a new unit study. So that easy. That's why I like these. They're super easy to switch out. Now inside this, these are all the papers that my daughter completed for human body. I will probably just staple it and hold it till the end of the school year, and then I'll kind of decide, am I keeping it? Am I tossing it? You know, that kind of struggle that I think we all go through because we'll just have piles of papers. But what I did, because with these like little three-prong holders, whenever I put actual paper in them, the paper would rip. It's just too much like pressure on these. And so I got these clear protective sheets, and I just put those in there in the prong, and then I can just insert whatever pages they need, and then they can pull them out, whatever. They normally do like a completed folder, and that's it. So that's how I keep these pretty easy to like use. And so I will put those activity sheets from Bookshark, and then I always go on like Etsy or Teachers Pay Teachers to just find like pretty printouts. And so I found, and I will link her shop below, I think it's called Wild Feather Education. She has like watercolor like images that go with like so many different like unit topics. I bought some a few weeks ago for North America, and I was like, oh, let me see if she has some for like volcanoes. And so she had the layers of the earth, and so it's a very pretty watercoloring drawing, pretty font of the layers of the earth, and then some more detailed description cards as well. And then the volcano eruption and the labeling of all the volcano parts, where all Earth's major volcanoes are. And so these are just like really pretty reference guides. I will probably laminate these and then hole punch them and put them in here just for more reference, because these are super pretty and I can see them wanting to keep these more. And so I will see what I do with those. But basically that is it with the activities. And then each of my girls has their own that they can just grab and work through. And so that is how I put together this volcano unit study, but in very just a basic general idea, that's how I put together all of our unit studies. So I try to find what I have around the house first, because I watch all these YouTube videos, I'm all over Instagram, and I see all these cool things, and I'm like, oh, we're doing a animal marine biology unit in 2 years. I need that now. And I'll buy like a cool kit or a book that will go with it, and then I kind of forget about it. And so it's almost like you have to go shopping in your stuff first. Now, I'm not saying that I won't buy new stuff. Obviously, I buy new stuff, but for this volcano unit, because I want it to end by our next school quarter, I don't want to add any more on. I think what we have is plenty enough. I think 2 to 3, it's probably going to be about 2.5 weeks on this topic is just fine. I have a second grader and a fourth grader. I don't think they need much more than that. We're going to finish reading 2 books on it. We'll be good. So I will try to link everything down below. Remember, this is a free unit study from Bookshark. I will link it down below. You just need to get this book, and that is all you need. They do all the other planning for you. But as you saw, I had some additional resources for you guys. So if you need a fun quick, easy science unit, go ahead and check this one out. They have, I think, about four other ones as well. I've done a couple videos on them, but this is the first one that we're actually going to be doing. And so if you guys want an update on it, make sure you leave that down below in the comments. Thanks so much for watching today's video. I hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye, guys.